provide to Teamcenter interactive supports importing or re-importing small amounts of data into Teamcenter. In this video you see how Add to Teamcenter Interactive is used to add an unmanaged assembly into Teamcenter. From the Add to Teamcenter Interactive startup screen, you can log in or start a new session and add documents to Teamcenter. Add to Teamcenter Interactive works with your data in discrete sessions. A session begins when you either select the Start New Session and Add Document command from the startup screen, select the New Session command from the File menu, or select the Add Document to Teamcenter command from Solid Edge. The Open dialog box displays documents you can select to add to Teamcenter. You can select a single document or multiple documents. The engine assembly is used for this demonstration. The Add to Teamcenter Interactive screen is divided into four window panes. The Unmanaged pane displays a bill of material view of your assembly and its properties. The Managed pane displays content from Teamcenter much like common property dialog boxes in Solid Edge Embedded Client. The Progress log displays information about your working session. The Error Assistant provides details and suggestions for corrective action to resolve issues discovered during your session. Session Settings is used to define the parameters for this session. For each session, you can set several options. For this session, we will set a revision rule for the documents being imported into Teamcenter. Because this command accesses Teamcenter, you must log into Teamcenter by providing your credentials. Once you're logged into Teamcenter, you can continue. Now that you are logged in, you can display the list of available revision rules. The revision rule latest working opens the latest item revision regardless of the release status. The Find All Linked Documents command locates the documents associated with the assembly chosen for import into Teamcenter. The documents related to the assembly selected as input to Teamcenter are added to the unmanaged pane. The progress log summarizes the activity and displays the time it took to complete the action. The Find All Related Drafts command locates any drawings associated with the assembly. The associated draft documents and their properties are inserted into the unmanaged list of documents as children of the objects they reference. The plus symbol beside engine1.par expands the rows for the engine. Here is a draft document and its properties. One of the most important aspects of preparing unmanaged documents is knowing their overall readiness to be added to the managed environment. The Issues column provides this information. The cells in the Issues column can display green, yellow, or red to indicate the corresponding document's readiness to be input to the managed environment. Green indicates no action is required. Red indicates corrective action must be taken before you add the document to Teamcenter. Details are provided when the cell is clicked. The Error Assistant pane indicates a broken link and provides suggestions for corrective action. Right-clicking the highlighted cell provides additional information. The Repair Link command is used to resolve the broken link identified in the Issues column. In this example, the linked file is located in the Parts folder. Open selects the document. The broken link is resolved. The Run Unmanaged Validations command is used to check for duplicate file names, duplicate item IDs, and duplicate revisions. The yellow cells in the Issues column indicate caution should be taken before the documents are added to Teamcenter. The Error Assistant notes that a key property value is empty. In this case, this is a new document, so no action is required. If, however, this were a previously managed document, the properties should have values defined in the existing item revision. This information persists in the Error Assistant until you click a different cell in the Issues column. Modifications are saved by clicking Save Properties. The Retrieve Data from Teamcenter command compares your unmanaged data with any pre-existing Teamcenter data. Any managed information is displayed in the Managed pane. Documents that have never been added to the managed environment have a Teamcenter action of new. Red asterisks indicate required properties. The Assign All command assigns an item ID, item name, and revision to the items in the new assembly. The Run Teamcenter Validations command verifies your managed data. The Issues column in the Managed pane indicates that your documents are ready for import into Teamcenter. You can save items to a folder you specify in the folder cell. Right-clicking the folder cell for the top-level assembly displays a list of shortcut commands. The Select Folder command displays a list of folders you can choose from. In this example, the items will be saved to the folder named Engine. The contents of the folder cell can be copied and pasted until each cell in the column displays the Engine folder. The Perform Actions command writes property data defined during the session to the unmanaged documents, corrects links, integrates the documents with existing managed data, and uploads them to Teamcenter. The Add to Teamcenter Status dialog box provides details regarding the progress of importing your files into Teamcenter. Once import is complete, you can return to Add to Teamcenter Interactive. The progress log indicates whether the import to Teamcenter passed or failed. Successful import of your documents into Teamcenter completes the session.